Occasionally, I find myself getting pleased with how I'm doing as a follower of Jesus. And occasionally, just occasionally, I get a little bit up myself in terms of like, oh, I've been really good at, you know, following you lately, Jesus, and loving you and giving to people and serving people and all that sort of stuff. And then I come back to this passage that we read from Mark chapter 14. And the point that I want to make from this passage is that Jesus, on the darkest night the whole world has ever known throughout the entirety of history, on the darkest night, the most significant point, Jesus was alone and he did it by himself. And there are a number of things, one after the other, that show us that. The first one is when they're eating the Last Supper together and he says, one of you will betray me. And they're saddened by that, and you know, they question that, but he's right. Obviously, Jesus goes ahead and betrays him. The next thing is, he says, do you see that in verse 27? You will all fall away. These are his closest friends, the people he's spent life with for 3 years. They've eaten together, they've chatted together, they've shared hearts, they've slept around a campfire at night together. And he says to them now, in his hour of darkness and need, you will all fall away, all of you. And then, of course, Peter speaks up and says, not me. But we know that he denies him. And then the very next thing that happens is Jesus takes him to Gethsemane, and here he goes and prays, and he takes his closest friends with him. He says it's Peter, James and John, his three best mates. And he's in anguish, you know, and he's so distressed. And he says, my soul is overwhelmed, you know, stay and keep watch with me. And they fall asleep. In his hour of need, they're there falling asleep. He comes back and he says, can you not even, you know, keep awake? And he says, I know you're willing, like the spirit's willing, but the flesh is weak. Come and stay awake with me. And they can't. They fall asleep again a third time, and he doesn't wake them a third time. And you see that Jesus does, he goes to the cross alone, and he goes through his greatest hour of torment alone, apart from, and this isn't a significant apart from, the Father who is there with him. What we see here is that God accomplishes salvation without my help and without your help. And he will eventually accomplish his purposes through history. And he wants to use us, and he delights in using us. And he's, you know, he works through us. But ultimately, at the end of the day, it rests on him. And for me, that causes two reactions. One is, it reminds me I'm not all that. And I think humility. And the second reaction is gratefulness. Wow, Jesus, you went through that dark night all alone, and you did it for me.